And we've got a couple of House of Lords related stories coming up next. Inside the Metro, the headline there, Corbyn, in inverted commas, because it's not been confirmed, puts anti-Brexit Burko up for peerage, is the headline. Dear.
Yes, well, from the monarchy to the Lords, you do wonder what century we're living in. My view on the Lords is very straightforward. It should be abolished. I think it's unbelievable that we have an unelected second chamber, which can sit in judgment on the elected chamber, or at least kind of, you know, pore over laws and say
checks and balances.
Checks and balances and all that kind of stuff. And the fact that Corbyn is putting forward Burko, reportedly, I think sums up the rotten nature of the House of Lords, where it is very often you push forward friends, colleagues, allies. He's also apparently going to put forward Tom Watson and Gary Murphy, who was a very close Corbyn ally, and didn't do a particularly good job of steering Labour in the general election. So that's open for question. Someone has said that he's rewarding failure. But I think the point is that the House of Lords strikes many, many people right now as an incredibly undemocratic institution. We know that it spent a lot of time trying to block Brexit. Many peers said, you know, we've got to hold this up as much as possible. And I think to a lot of people, the idea of having these unelected peers, whether it's incredibly posh people or modern day do-gooders, sitting in judgment on what people vote for just strikes us as wrong. So I think actually what Corbyn ought to have done, if he is the radical he suggests he is, he should start a debate about the Lords rather than filling it with his friends.
Well, and Rebecca Long-Bailey, I think, has said that as part of the Labour leadership race, hasn't she? But do you think there's a public appetite to reform the House of Lords?
I don't think there's a huge public appetite to reform it. I think actually we're going to get such a reformist Tory party over the next 5 years that I think we're all going to be sick to death of reform in about 5 minutes. But I mean, I'm less concerned about the do-gooders and really more concerned about the do-badders. I think Carrie Murphy, you know, behaved very, very badly. She presided over the anti-Semitism scandal in the Labour Party, and it's currently being investigated by the Equalities and Human Rights Commission, the only party apart from the BNP ever to be investigated for racism. So the idea that she should be given a peerage before they have even pronounced and given their verdict is absolutely crazy.
Okay.
But the whole system does depend on favours from presiding politicians, and I think it's very undemocratic.
Okay, let's move on to the other element of the Lords story. We're trying to squeeze these things if we can. Inside the Financial Times, move out of London for Lords considered. And this
yeah,
is,
well, I think this kind of slightly amused me, not because it's a bad idea to move the Lords out of London. I think, you know, why should everything be in London? But simply because I think for the next 5 years, everything is going to be seen through the prism of, is it going to please the red wall? And these are the only people in the country who matter now, the people who used to vote Labour and who have now voted for Boris Johnson and who he is desperate to keep on side. So this will be a gesture about showing we're not just in the metropolitan bubble. We have Lords in, you know, York.
But is it, you think it's a gesture, but is it an important symbol, do you think, Brendan, so that people don't feel that everything's decided in London, miles away from where they live and completely divorced from their way of life?
Well, I do think doing things that will please Red Wall voters is actually very important. I mean, Christina says they're the only people who matter at the moment, but for a very long time they didn't matter at all and no one took their concerns seriously. So I think that's it's a good policy to think about what will please those parts of the country. But I don't think moving the Lords up to the north is a good idea. It should be moved into the dustbin of history, in my view. I just think that would be a small gesture that wouldn't address the underlying problem with it.
Okay, well, we are out of time. We want to talk a little bit about Stormzy. We might do that at 11:30. You'll both be back then anyway, and you can decide what you want to talk about. Anyway, we'll see you then. Thanks.